welcome to social sciences class to all young minds. Today we are going to come across the content related to, in this video we are going to come across the content related to Indian Muslim League, IML. What is this IML? Important question, maybe asked but for 4 marks, at times 2 marks, certain concepts related to IML, 2 marks, and dates, names, this may be for half mark in the very, very short or objective questions. So we have to learn things with very utmost care, and some stats also will be there coming in between the concept. We should be aware about it. Seen on a Indian Muslim League took its birth in 1906, already we came across. And because of their demand to protect their rights, political rights, a separate electorate in all councils was granted by British government to them. According to Minto Mowlai reforms, or the recommendations given by Minto Mowlai reforms were made as Government of India Act 1909. We know that. And this Muslim League was formed because of the abetment or encouragement made by the British government and some feudal lords or landlords of UP or United Provinces of the day. Now Uttar Pradesh we can call. Those people floated this particular political organization called Indian Muslim League with the support of the British. Almost all up to 1937-40, we can call. It did not get much support from the Muslim masses. Feudal lords, landlords are there, but rich people are there, but the ordinary common people did not show any interest to join with the Indian Muslim League. It was not that popular. Surprising things will be coming across. Got it? Where it was very strong, there it did not get won in the 1937 elections. Where more number of Muslims are there it have to win, but it did not win in the 1937 election. But scenario underwent a change by 1946. Within 10 years, what happened? Why most majority of Indian Muslims rallied at the back of Indian Muslim League? What it? We are going to learn about those things right now in this particular concept. Right, first thing. Indian Muslim League was successful in getting its demand of separate electorate, and now Muslims belonging to different political parties got an opportunity to contest in the elections, in 1937 elections that were held into the provinces, provincial assemblies, got it, and provincial councils, got it. So, and what happened in 1937 election, you see in 1937, IML and IMC, separate constituencies are there now. In 482 constituencies or council seats, IML contested. 482 into 1, only 102 seats. See, what was 1/4 only was support from the Muslim community to IML, Indian Muslim League. Whereas Congress, which contested for 58 Muslim without seats, Muslim candidates were made to be contested by Congress. Muslims only contested, because once a seat is reserved for any community, only that community people have to contest in the election from any political party. Some seat is reserved for SC. People belonging from the SC community only have to contest in that particular seat. Any party, either Congress, TRS, BJP, TDP, CPI, CPM, only people belonging to that particular community should be offered a ticket by candidature by that political party. Okay, India also Congress made 58. People from on its behalf to contest in the Muslim reserved seats, but it was able to win only 20 seats. And what was the vote share of Indian Muslim League? among the Muslim community. Only 4.4% of it was educated. And what happened to the remaining percentage of votes? Remaining percentage of votes were Congress, Indian National Congress, Unionist Party, like many other parties are there in different parts of the country. They got a great success. And something surprising is, Indian Muslim League got more number of seats in United Province. UP means United Province, not Uttar Pradesh. UP means here United Province. We are talking before independence, but it before the formation of our states. So UP means United Province. And Bombay Presidency, Madras, they got more number of seats and compared to the areas where it was very strong. What are the states it was very strong? Means where more number of Muslims are there. The states where more number of Muslims are there are Bengal, Punjab, Northwest Frontier Province. Northwest Frontier Province is now in Pakistan or Tajikistan. Northern part of Pakistan is the present Pakistan. See, okay. See, here Northwest Frontier Province will be near the Baluchistan, Pakistan. But it Baluchistan is here. So, in this region, and in Punjab, Muslims were more. Punjab and Sindh in Pakistan, Sindh will be there now. Sindh and Punjab will be there. So they, in these states where Muslims, in Bengal also, Muslims are more. But in Bangladesh, East Pakistan, that it became East Bengal at the time. In the Bengal also, both East Bengal and West Bengal, good number of Muslims are there, but in the state of Bengal, in the state of Punjab and Sindh, where Muslims are more, and Northwest Frontier Province, which is in Pakistan, there in 1937 elections, it got minimum number of seats. Maximum seats were swept over by Congress and Nationalist Party, Unionist Party, and so on, some other political parties. But Indian Muslim League did not get majority Muslim support in that particular state, which got formed as Pakistan in the later course of time. Pakistan, what is Pakistan? This is Pakistan. This is Pakistan. Okay. And this is Pakistan. There, where the more number of Muslims are there, is Indian Muslim League failed to win the seats in 1937. It was able to bag only 4.4% of Muslim community votes. But it, the same Indian Muslim League by 1946 got 86% of Muslim community votes done. 86%, and it got 442 seats out of 509 seats in the provincial councils. In all provinces, there are 509 seats. Earlier, 482 was the number increased. And out of that, earlier it was able to get 102, only 144. But now it got a maximum seats. Almost what we can call, for it is nothing but 80% of seats they won, which are reserved for Muslims. 86% of Muslim votes they won. 80% of seats also they got won in the constituencies which are reserved for Muslims. Means what made the mind of Muslims to undergo a change? Why they rallied behind Muslim League, Indian Muslim League, leaving Indian National Congress or Unionist Party, so on, which is very, Unionist Party was very strong in Punjab. Punjab is not, both India and in India and also in Pakistan, it was very strong. Muslim Party, it was also led by Muslims only. But whereas Indian National Congress got 91% of non-Muslim votes in the same election, in 1946 election. Yeah, of course, it also won a good number of seats which are not reserved for Muslims, almost 90% of seats. So that is which are not reserved. Reserved seats went all majority 80% of seats went in favor of Indian Muslim League only. And it vindicated, he says, it means it proved. A word is used to vindicate. Vindicated means witnessed or proved. It indicated a word in English. It got proved. Got proved or witnessed. Or witnessed. What did it prove? This Muslim community, Muslim League was saying that I am the representative of Muslim community. No others are there, Unionist Party or someone is not there. Any decision you have to make according to my demand only, was the saying of Indian Muslim League to the British government. It stated itself as the spokesperson of Muslim community. Spokesperson means one who speaks on behalf of a political party or a group. Total all people can't speak. For example, if you or I want to be teachers have represented something to the chairman, sir. All of us go at a time and say, start talking, can you understand anything? No. Or if you people want to convey some problem or doubt to the teacher, all of you at a time stand and shout, teacher can? No, we'll make a friend of us, a leader, to go to the teacher and he will be talking to the teacher about the problem which is common to many students in the particular classroom. Then automatically teacher will be explaining it. Like that, one who takes a lead and acts as the voice of entire class in your classroom or from the staff room. Here Muslim League started acting as voice of Muslims. That's why it quoted itself as spokesperson of, means who will be speaking on behalf of Muslim community. And it was saying earlier onwards, no others have anything, we have much more concern to the Muslims and their problems in this country. And we are the people who will be taking care of the Muslim community in this country. At the time, India was united. So, we have right to speak on behalf of Muslims. Other than we, no others have any right. Unionist Party or some expanded party, even the Muslims led that, they are not. Because we have more popular support of the Muslims. Was the saying of Indian Muslim League before 1946 election, but which was not even weighted by the British government. But this elections of 1946 elections proved, yeah, what it is saying is right. But that, to say that it got proved, he used a word, vindicated, V-I-N-D-I-C-A-T-E-D, vindicated. Again in 18th chapter also we will come across this word vindicated, means got proved. But it, what is said by Indian Muslim got proved with the 1946 election that majority Muslims are with the Muslim League only. And what is the cause for this transformation, Nana? What is this cause? From 1937, it was nowhere. 1 by 4 only, or 25%, even votes are 4.4% only among Muslim community to this party. Got it? And what made now Muslim League to emerge a champion of Muslim community? There are certain factors. One is the lethargic attitude of negligence of Indian National Congress to Muslim community in its own party. And or we can say partiality shown by knowingly or unknowingly the top brass of leaders in Congress party showed some bias towards Muslim community in certain aspect. They could not realize until it was identified and put forward by one of the Muslim leader of Congress of that day. And many areas Muslim League tried to join Congress, but Muslim League was seen as a puppet in the hands of British and Congress kept it away. And this is also a cause for that thing. And also emergence of Hindu Mahasabha and Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, which are which bang around religious fanaticism. Got it? And finally, the advocacy made by Muhammad Ali Jinnah, one more communal leader. Got it? Who is also communal fanatic, religious fanatic. Got it? Who proposed the theory of two nations. Means India is, Indians are not one nation, there are two nations, that is, one section is Muslims, others are non-Muslims. And Muslims want a separate state, they don't want to be with the non-Muslims, he said. Two nation theory. Non-Muslims, one nation, Muslims, one nation. Was advocated by Muhammad Ali Jinnah. And also what else more he said about? These all things we are going to come across. Because of all these things only, Indian Muslim League became a champion of Muslim community by 1946. Within 10 years of time only, one decade only, it became very powerful among Muslim community. Right?
What happened?
In 1937 elections, in United Province, already I said, you know, here, United Province, Muslim League also got good number of seats along with Congress. They were very much enthusiastic to join the Indian government. They were very much enthusiastic to join the Indian government, good Muslim League. Indian Muslim League got good number of seats in 1937 elections in the United Province. A provincial government came to power under the leadership of Congress. But in Congress led government was there. They won Indian Muslim League as it got after Congress, it got good number of seats. It wanted to join the government. But Indian National Congress denied any benefit to this Indian Muslim League. Of course, Congress have its own argument. What is that? If it give birth to Muslim representatives, to people's representatives who got elected on behalf of Muslim League, and it have to forget giving birth to Muslims who are following Congress party. So then naturally when it won't give birth to its own Muslims, who are its own Muslims in the sense, the Muslims who are being a part of Congress, then naturally Muslims will be losing their faith in the Muslim International Congress. And even though we are not being in Muslim League, some Muslims who are being in the Indian Muslim League, they will get the belts by seeing that better. Muslims will be thinking that it will be better to be in the Indian Muslim League where we can get some opportunity rather than being in Congress. That feeling may develop among Muslim community of which is following Indian National Congress. And they are rendering their services for a long time. Congress want to accommodate their Muslims. That means Muslims who are there sailing with Congress for a long time. That's why it denied the proposal made by Indian Muslim League. And Indian Muslim League got an opportunity to foster Congress as a Hindu ideological party. It is not having any sympathy towards Muslims. Don't follow it, don't believe it. And not only this, one more activity also was a pass to the rise of Indian Muslim League, where it exposed the stepmother attitude of Congress. Stepmother, you all know, our real mother is not this, dad gets married someone, she is called stepmother, right? So, see here, Indian Muslim League, Congress party was very strong against those Muslims belonging to Congress party, moving with Indian Muslim League, closely with Indian Muslim League. At the same time, this certain leaders of Congress party are moving with the Hindu Mahasabha. What is this Hindu Mahasabha? Hindu Mahasabha and RSS are, Hindu Mahasabha and RSS are, Sabha, RSS, most particularly Hindu Mahasabha. RSS is Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh. Hindu Mahasabha was started by Madan Mohan Malviya, a professor, in 1915. It was started as an Hindu fundamental organization, which will be speaking about only merits of Hindus, and it strongly believed Hindustan for Hindus. Hindustan for Hindus mean non-Hindus have to leave this country was the argument of Hindu Mahasabha. Right. 1915 it was just a particular, not a particular organization, no, it's a social organization. And then after it became 1933, it became a political organization by 1933. And Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh, its ideology is nationalism, Indianism, got it? So even RSS, Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh, Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh, Swayam Sevak Sangh, This was started by, this is in UP, Hindu Mahasabha principal, in Banaras Hindu University, we can call. Whereas last year, Swayam Sevak Sangh took its birth in Nagpur, Maharashtra. Nagpur, Maharashtra. And the man who founded it is Keshav Baliram Hegdewar in 1925. RSS took its birth in 1925 at Nagpur. And founder is Keshav Rao Baliram Hegdewar. Keshav Rao Baliram Hegdewar, RSS founder in 1955, Nagpur. It is having an Indianism. That means what Indian culture is there that should be protected well. And all India belongs to it, the people who follow Indian culture only. And these two are nations want to bring, they want to eliminate caste system in Hinduism, and they want to bring all Hindus together and onto one plank, or onto one dais, or one venue, or one platform. They want to bring all Hindus by removing the caste system. And they don't want non-Hindus staying in India. With this aggressive ideology, this organization started functioning. And when some Congress men were moving with the Hindu Mahasabha and RSS, Congress did not raise any objection. Purely they are having somewhat Hindu heretical ideology. Whereas Indian Muslim League, which is having some heretical ideology related to Muslims, that the Muslims who are in Congress when they were moving with the Indian Muslim League, same Congress rose an objection. It asked that if you want to be with Indian Muslim League, be with them. Don't be in Congress. If you don't want to be in the Indian Muslim League and don't want to move with that, be in Congress. It said. But coming to the certain leaders of Congress at the top brass, when they were moving close with Hindu Mahasabha and Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh, Congress was a spectator and silent spectator. It was a silent spectator. And this was pointed by Congress could not realize and recognize what is the fact till the Congress leader Abul Kalam Azad, not APJ sir, our first education minister in independent India. So Abul Kalam Azad, he pointed this issue in one of the Congress meetings. What is this dual standard? When certain Muslims belonging to party are moving with Indian Muslim League, you are raising an objection. When these fellows are also moving with certain Hindu leaders of Congress are moving with Hindu Mahasabha, which is also a political organization, because 1913 it became a political organization. Why you are not stopping? They are advocating for religious fanaticism, like Indian Muslim League. And why you are not raising your voice against this? A question was made by Abul Kalam Azad. And this gave an opportunity to the Muslim leaders of Indian Muslim League to take a campaign that Congress is a Hindu ideological party. It is against Muslims. So no use being in Congress. If you are there in Congress, you will be getting injustice. Was the saying of Indian Muslim League to Muslim community. But the fellow who had a strong impact and had a strong stamp on the minds of Muslim community, people of Muslim community, was Muhammad Ali Jinnah. What did Muhammad Ali Jinnah said? Two nation theory. What is the theory advocated by him? Important question, na? Important question, two nation theory. This may be asked for 1 mark, 2 marks, got it? Or what are the causes for partition of India? These all things what I just explained now, all those things you have to write. Indian Muslim, how, what was the status of Indian Muslim League, when it got formed, what was its status in 1937 election, what is its status in 1946 election, what are the colors won Congress, how Congress was called, and how Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh Hindu Mahasabha was. And they are giving a slogan, what? In Hindustan for Hindus, non-Hindus have to leave the country. Hindus Mahasabha RSS, right? And Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Theory of advocated by Muhammad Ali Jinnah, two nation theory. What is this two nation theory? Indians are not a single nation. They are two nations. One is Muslims and other is non-Muslims, was saying of Muhammad Ali Jinnah. And he asked all the Muslims to come together. And if they are united, Muslims are united, we can have a separate country, two nations. Here of India will be not a single nation. Non-Muslims will be one nation called India, and the Muslim community will be getting divided from this India, and it will be forming Pakistan. Pakistan means holy land. Got it? It will be forming into a holy land, was the saying of Mr. Muhammad Ali Jinnah. So this Muhammad Ali Jinnah, to attract masses, he started a speeches or campaign, propaganda. What? He is a good orator. He started saying to Muslim community, see my dear brothers, Muslim brothers, in this big country, where majority are Hindus, we never get the justice. Our children can't get the education opportunities, or they can't make an entry into the education institution, because they will be dominated by educated Hindus who are already having higher education. Hindus, they will be encouraging their children, and we people want to compete with them. And when we go on computer, most of the seats will be occupied by Hindus only, and our children have to remain under education. Well, and most of the in India is having Hindu landlords, and the people who are working on the lands of that Hindu landlords are majority are Muslims. Majority are Muslims. And in case of trade and commerce, we can't compete with Hindu traders and commerce. But it, all education will be education, they will be dominating. And the people who are highly educated Muslims, they are there, they will never get an opportunity to prove themselves as good politicians. So, for all these miseries, only one solution, formation of Pakistan. If we get Pakistan, every job will be filled with Muslim only. Every education institution, only Muslim students will be there, non-Muslims won't be there. All the business will be controlled by only Muslims. All the landlords who are belonging to Hindu community will be made to run into India, and the land will be occupied by Muslims, and they will become owners. This is very powerful, you see. Who are working as agricultural laborers on the land of Hindu landlords, now they will become owners of the land. And automatically every Muslim who was struggling for his one-time meal and extending his fiscal services for the Hindu landlords, now got attracted towards Muhammad Ali Jinnah's speeches and Indian Muslim League. And he was saying, we can enjoy more religious freedom. If we get a separate state, need not we have any constitution what India is going to have, or something else. Our Sharia, which is the highest law of Islam, will be the constitution, and everyone have to live according to that constitution only. That law only, Sharia, Islamic law, which was advocated by Prophet Muhammad. So you see, we can have that freedom of our practicing our own religious aspects. If not, if we are forced to be Indians, Hindus, even we don't have any like towards that festivals or that ceremonies and so on, we should also be, because rulers will be there, we should also take part of band works in the two aspects. In this way, he started infusing into the mind of Muslim community, the strong desire of a separate state called Pakistan. And of course it became true by 1947. From 1940 onwards, he started it. And next we will come across Pakistan Resolution Nana, which is popularly called, but actually it is not. But it is. And that resolution, who made, what happened in the next video. And also certain thing related to Quit India movement, which was initiated by Mahatma Gandhi, next video. Thank you.